Hey guys, how's it going? So today we are looking at a 2-in-1 convertible laptop. This is one of the best selling laptops on Amazon in the 2-in-1 category, and it is the Acer Spin 3. So Acer has packed some high end specs in this thin and light 2-in-1 laptop, and they have done it while keeping the price at around $700. So I think this is a very aggressive pricing in the high end premium 2-in-1 laptop category. Now the price on Amazon tends to vary, so check out the links that I have put in the description to find the latest price as of now. Now Acer Spin 3, it's $700, but the question is it worth $700? Let's find out. Now, I love 2-in-1 laptops. They are so convenient and versatile. In 2020, if you are thinking of buying a laptop, my recommendation is to go with a 2-in-1 laptop form factor. Acer Spin 3 weighs about 3.75 pounds and it is only 0.78 inches thick. Now, in order to get to $700 price point, Acer made some compromises. So in this laptop, you will not find the fancy unibody metal design. It's actually made of polycarbonate or plastic. Now, in my opinion, this is not necessarily a bad thing because this keeps the weight of the laptop down. The laptop is fairly well built and it feels solid in hands. When you open the lid, you see a black texturized upper bezel and a glossy silver bottom. The silver finishing does a good job at repelling smudges and scratches. So whether you are a student or whether you are planning to use this laptop, you know, in your home, it should be able to handle your daily hustle quite well. Acer Spin 3, it's a hybrid form factor device. It comes with a 360 degree hinge mechanism. So there are two hinges that hold the screen in various arrangements. So from a traditional clamshell laptop to laying flat on a table, to tent mode, and finally to tablet mode. Typically the hinges on a convertible laptops, they tend to be not all that sturdy and they usually have some play in them. But Acer Spin 3, the hinge holds the screen in place quite rigidly. I did not notice any screen wobbles when using it in either laptop or in tablet mode. I especially prefer the mode where you tilt the screen back 180 degrees. This is great when you are chilling in your bed or, you know, in your couch when you are like watching videos on your laptop and your laptop is comfortably sitting on your lap. The tablet mode is great for using with included stylus. I often use sketching apps to doodle and to make stupid, cartoons. It helps me channel my inner artist. Now, I am not really an artist, but I still like doing it. So I really appreciate the stylus. Acer Spin 3, it has a 14-inch Full HD 1920 by 1080 widescreen display. It is an LED backlit IPS panel which supports multi-touch. The screen has very thin bezels measuring only 0.38 inches. This gives it a 78.9% screen-to-body ratio, which is pretty impressive for a 2-in-1 laptop screen. The screen is plenty bright, clocking about 240 nits of brightness. You will have no problem using this laptop in bright lit environments. So whether you are in a classroom or say you are in a conference room, you should be good and the screen is plenty bright. The contrast level is also quite good and the screen produces really deep inky blacks. This screen has a wide viewing angle of 178 degrees. So that means, you know, the text and images, they are going to look sharp even at skewed angles. The screen supports full Windows 10 multi-touch features. Spin 3 comes with a rechargeable active stylus that docks right into the laptop. The stylus is perfect for taking notes, for drawing, for sketching. I think students and working professionals, they will find it very useful. As I mentioned before, Acer Spin 3 has a built-in storage dock for the stylus, and the dock also acts as a charging station. So it will charge your stylus when, you know, you dock it. And it's really fast charging. So just 5 seconds in the dock will juice up the stylus for about an hour's use. This rechargeable active stylus is certified by Microsoft, and it integrates the Microsoft Pen protocol. This means you can use it with various apps, including my favorite, you know, the Microsoft OneNote. This is really handy, and I appreciate the fact that Acer is including a stylus with their laptop. You know, companies like Apple, they charge $130 for their Apple Pencil. So thanks, Acer. Thank you for not fleecing your customers. Okay, let's talk about the hardware specs. Acer Spin 3 comes with Core i7 processor. Specifically, this is 8th generation Core i7-8565U from the Intel Whiskey Lake family. This is a pleasant surprise because most of the 2-in-1 hybrid laptops in this price point, they use a slower processor. So again, I will give kudos to Acer for picking a high-end Core i7 processor. This is a 4-core, 8-thread processor, and it has a base clock speed of 1.8 GHz, and the max turbo frequency is 4.6 GHz. This CPU has a TDP threshold of 15 watts, so it is able to automatically overclock itself from 1.8 to 4.6 GHz while still maintaining the 15 watt thermal envelope. So as a result, Spin 3 can deliver snappy performance while still remaining cool. In Passmark CPU benchmark, this CPU scores around 8,832 points. And if you compare this performance with the top 10 common laptop CPUs, you will see that this processor is sitting in the second spot. So for a thin and light 2-in-1 laptop category, I think this is a kick-ass CPU. You will not have any trouble running any application or game on this laptop. I was able to open more than 50 Chrome browser tabs and seamlessly switch between them without any stuttering or without any kind of slowness. So I am very happy with the CPU performance on this laptop. So this laptop is using the Intel integrated USD 620 graphics. This is a pretty capable GPU and it produces 37 frames per second on the DIRT 3 benchmark. Now this is above the playability threshold, which is usually around 30 frames per second. So you will be able to, you know, do casual gaming on this laptop without any issues. It also supports hardware acceleration for all popular codecs like H.264, AVC and VP9. This means smooth 4K video playback on YouTube and Netflix with no dropped frames. But remember, this is an integrated GPU, so don't expect Nvidia or AMD level, you know, discrete GPU class performance. And if you are planning to do hardcore gaming, then I guess you are better off buying a gaming laptop. I have reviewed plenty of awesome gaming laptops on this channel, and I'm going to throw a link in the description of, you know, some of the gaming laptops which I recommend. So, you know, you can go out and check those reviews. So this laptop, it comes with 16 gig of DDR4 system memory. I'm really happy to see Acer not skimp on memory. To get the best performance on any modern laptop, in my opinion, you need at least 16 gig of RAM. And I really hate it when companies sell expensive laptops and yet they give you only 8 gig of RAM. Now, if you think 16 gig is not good enough for you, you can always upgrade the RAM. The existing 16 gig RAM, it's split into two parts. 8 gig RAM is soldered to the motherboard and this cannot be expanded. But luckily, the remaining 8 gig, it's installed on a standard DIMM slot and that is user upgradable. So you can replace this 8 gig RAM stick with a compatible 16 gig RAM stick for about $50. So this is going to bump up your total system RAM to 24 gig, which I think is going to be, you know, totally awesome. So I will throw a link in the description of the compatible memory module that is going to work with this laptop, and you know, you can get it from Amazon for about $50. When it comes to storage, this laptop has a generous 512 gig of fast PCIe NVMe SSD storage. During my file transfer test, I was able to copy over a 5 gig of video file in under 9 seconds. So I think that's pretty impressive, and it is faster than competing ultrabooks like Asus ZenBook 13 and HP X360. 512 gig of storage should be sufficient for most folks, but if you want increased storage, you know, you can always swap this SSD and, you know, you can get a bigger SSD. So to do that, you will have to open the back of the laptop, and once you remove the back, you have direct access to the M.2 slot, and you can remove the existing SSD with a bigger SSD in this M.2 slot. I'm going to throw a link in the description of compatible SSDs if you are interested in upgrading your SSD. But remember one thing, guys, if you are planning to upgrade the SSD, you will have to clone the Windows operating system from the older SSD to the newer SSD. The SSD that I have linked below in the description, it will come with a free cloning software, so you can use that software to back up, you know, your Windows operating system. But if you don't want to, you know, mess with the upgrading the hardware and cloning Windows operating system, you can always buy an external USB drive. So that's what I do actually for backing up all the pictures, videos and my personal documents. So I will throw a link in the description of a, you know, a affordable and a compatible USB external drive that you can use to back up your data. So Acer claims 12 hours of battery life on a single charge. But in my testing, which involved web surfing over Wi-Fi at about 150 nits of brightness, I only got about 7 to 7.5 hours of battery life. So definitely you are not going to get a 12 hour battery life as claimed by Acer. I think for an ultrabook, this is a decent battery life performance, but I wish it was little better. I wouldn't call it an all day battery life. If you are able to charge your laptop for about 30 minutes, you know, during the day, then I think you can stretch it out for the whole day. So I think for students who are planning to use this laptop in classroom, I think you guys should be fine. The thermal heat dissipation on this laptop is pretty good. After watching videos on Netflix and YouTube for about 30 minutes, I checked the laptop body and it still felt cool. There was no heating and definitely there was no, you know, loud fan cranking at high throttle. This is primarily due to well-designed heatsink and a fan which is doing a great job at keeping the laptop cool. Okay, so moving on to the keyboard, Acer Spin 3, it has an island style keyboard which is backlit enabled. The keyboard has a regular layout and all the keys are in their right place, so you will not have like your control, shift or alt key in stupid places. I think the keys are well placed and they do feel comfortable when typing. The keys are also quite responsive and the key travel is around 1 millimeter. They offer an actuation force of about 80 grams, which gives a nice tactile feedback. The keyboard deck is made of smoothly textured plastic and it feels very comfortable when your palm is resting on it. I would say that for a thin and light laptop design, this is an excellent keyboard. Acer has also included a fingerprint sensor on the top left corner of the trackpad. This extra level of biometric security is a nice welcome addition. Now, I am personally really bad when it comes to coming up with a secure password. So I really appreciate a built-in fingerprint sensor in my laptop. Just like our phones, I think this should be in all the laptops. So this laptop, it has a large 4.1 by 2.6 inches trackpad. The trackpad is made of plastic, but it is very clicky and responsive. It comes with Windows Precision drivers and handles swipes, gestures, taps, and palm rejection really well. Whether you are zooming in or scrolling through web pages, Windows 10 gestures work like a charm on this trackpad. Okay, so now let's move on to the speakers. So Spin 3, it comes with a dual front-facing speakers and they provide loud audio with decent bass. The speakers are hidden behind the grill at the top of the keyboard. I really like this placement of speakers because they are facing you in both laptop and in tablet mode. The maximum volume is around 74 decibel and even at the top volume, I could not hear any distortion. So I was pretty impressed with these little speakers. They are actually better than most of the other Ultrabooks, which usually tend to have very tinny speakers. So in this laptop, you also get a decent selection of ports. There are full-size USB ports. There is an HDMI port for connecting to an external monitor and you also get an SD card reader. But unfortunately, there is no USB Type-C port, which kind of sucks. I mean, 2020 is almost upon us and I think every laptop should now ship with at least one USB Type-C port. Okay, so here are my final thoughts on this laptop. I think for $700, this laptop, I think it's a steal. There are no thin and light laptop currently in the market at this price point, which are offering comparable performance. So I will have to give kudos to Acer for creating an affordable 2-in-1 premium Ultrabook that is equipped with a kick-ass Core i7 processor. It has 16 gig of RAM. You're also getting a nice touchscreen. You are getting a free stylus with the laptop. You are getting great stereo speakers. So overall, I think this laptop, it's great for both students and also for professionals, and they are going to find it a solid purchase. So check out the links in the description. I have put links to both the laptop. I have put links to compatible RAM and SSD that I talked about. So guys, I hope you found this video useful. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below and I will try to help you guys. Please like this video and subscribe to Techno Panda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, TVs, monitors and any other gadget. Again, thanks for watching my video and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.